Nathan Oakley has added to his never-ending stream of silly statements yet another one. That in itself isn't a surprise, but with this one, he has ruined his even sillier Black Swan argument completely. You can measure the angle to a star with a sextant in several different ways. The most secure ones are those with the bubble sextants, a pendulum sextant, or an inclinometer. But the most common one is with an ordinary sextant aimed at the horizon. Because the horizon always lies beneath the eye height of the observer, you need a dip correction to get an accurate reading. According to Nathan Oakley, who acknowledges the necessity of a dip correction, the dip correction is nothing more than the correction for the height of the observer above the surface. As Oakley puts it, dip corrects for the height of eye above the plane. Let's assume that he is right, and that is not a begging the question fallacy. The dip correction in the nautical almanac is given in arc minutes. So you have an observer at a certain height h, which gives the almanac a dip angle of alpha. Since it is the horizon that is at play here, you can, using these two values, calculate the distance to the horizon d. The general formula for this distance will be d equals h divided by the tangent of alpha. For an observer height of 1 foot, the accepted dip angle is around 1 arc minute. The tangent of 1 arc minute, that is 0.0167 degrees, equals 0.000291. 1 foot divided by 0.000291 equals 3,438 feet. This equals 0.651 miles. According to the formula used by the flat earthers, the horizon on a globe should be at 1.22 miles with an eye height of 1 foot. So the horizon on a flat earth should be closer by than on a spherical earth. In other words, modus tollens, if the Earth is flat, for an observer height of 1 foot, the horizon would be at 0.651 miles. In the Black Swan photo, the horizon is clearly much farther away than 9.4 miles. So, bye-bye flat! This is what you get with flat earthers who try to explain the inexplicable by inventing ever new explanations, without worrying whether those explanations might contradict explanations invented earlier for another inexplicable event.